tell me that Syria will tell you next time. But suddenly he said, I didn't know what happened. In fact, that day, he did not know what happened. He cannot even say how he get to office. But he just know that when he was signing, it was not yet 2 o'clock. That he cannot even, he tried to recall, how did I enter Bebu? Did I enter Usudi? Or did I enter? That he could not recall how he got to office. He knew he took a vehicle. But he just saw that when he was clocking in, it was not yet 2 o'clock. It was my time to yell him. I said, you see now? You see what my daughter done? When I was talking to you the other time, you were saying I should ask questions. I told him the other time. He said, Pastor, I believe. I said, no, tell me you believe. Now is the time you are telling me you believe. Amen. Now, what am I saying? Even when what you are asking is impossible, your asking will make it possible. Why? Because the status of the one that gave the promise. Now, what is the status of the one that gave this promise? Amen. Why I should hold on or I should believe this promise? Number one, amen. The first thing I want you to know about him that gave this promise is that he is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he a son of man that he should repent. That's the first thing you know about him. Numbers chapter 19, verse 23. Numbers 23, verse 19. He said, God is not a man that he should lie. Neither the son of man that he should repent. He said, as he said it, will he not do it? Whatever he says, he does. Amen. He is not a man. He can't lie. So when he says, ask and shall be given, he is not lying. Whatever he says, he will do. Isaiah chapter 55, from verse 10 to 11. Oh, God said, he said, as the rain comes from heaven and wets the ground. Amen. When the rain comes from heaven, it doesn't go back halfway. Amen. It must touch ground. You understand what I'm saying now? His purpose of leaving heaven is to what? Is to wet the ground. He says, so is my word that proceeds out of my mouth. It must accomplish the purpose for which it is sent. Amen. So if the word says, ask, you should be given, then rest assured that when you ask, you will be given. I am trusting God that somebody will ask this morning. Yeah. And surely you will be given. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Why should I believe that promise? Because of his status. Let me tell you another thing about his status. Number two, the one that gave that promise is the Almighty. He has power over all. Amen. So he can compel whatever you are asking to come to you. If what you are asking is under a stronghold, he can snatch it and give it to you. Why? Because he is the Almighty. Genesis chapter 17 verse 1. Genesis chapter 17 verse 1. Oh, he said to Abraham, he said, I am the Almighty means all power belongs unto him. Amen. In supreme. Amen. In supreme. Maybe what you are asking for is under the control of the mighty. Amen. When the Almighty appear, the mighty must surrender. Maybe what you are asking for, the mighty is preventing it. When the Almighty appear, the what? The mighty must what? Must give way. So, therefore, believe. As you ask this morning, you shall be given. Amen. Revelation chapter 1, verse 8. Revelation chapter 1 verse 8, it says, I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, and the ending. Amen. The Almighty. I mean, God is saying to you, the one that cannot lie, he says, is what? Is the Almighty. Amen. Is the Almighty. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 11. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 11. It said, beside him there is no other God. Amen. There is no one, there is nothing that is as strong as he is.
Amen.
So therefore, nothing can stop whatever he has asked to be released. Amen. Isaiah 44 verse 6, he said again and again, he said, is the Almighty, and beside him there is no other God. The same thing in Isaiah 44 verse 8, amen. Isaiah 44 verse 8, amen, is God and there is no one in his class. Is a God alone in his own class. It's beside me there is no one. So there is no other God. So maybe if it is other gods that are in charge, amen, maybe they are taking your matter into one God in the village, the one idol, maybe the God of the iron or the God of the river, amen. And they say, well, you are, you know, you can't have it. When the God of gods say release, there is no God before him. He must what? He must release. So what is it that you are asking for? A God that there is no other God beside you, he said to you, just ask me, you shall be given. Amen. So friend, release your faith. Because somebody is going to ask. And somebody you are going to get today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Matthew 28 verse 18. Matthew 28 verse 18. He said, all power belongs to him, both in heaven and underneath the earth. Maybe what you are asking for is in heaven. He has the power to drop it. Maybe it's not in the air. He has the power to bring it out. Amen. Maybe I need to tell you another of the startups. One that say, ask which shall be given. Maybe that will encourage you to release your faith tonight. But the third thing I want to tell you about that, he created all things. Amen. He created how many things? So whatever you are asking is the creator. You understand what I'm saying now? No matter what you are asking is who? Is the creator. So if the creator, the one that created all things, tells you that ask, he will give it. Why won't you believe that? He created it. Amen. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Amen. John chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. John chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. Amen. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Amen. And the Word was God. Amen. The same was in the beginning with God. Verse 3 says, you know, by him all things were created, and nothing was created that were created. Amen. All things. So the one that said ask, he created what you are asking. Amen. He created what you are asking. Amen. He created it. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 9. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 9 tells us, created all things. Amen. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. Somebody might say, you say he created all things. What I'm asking for is not visible. So, I mean, we are not talking about what was created. Amen. You know, some people, what they are asking for to them is not visible. Amen. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16 says, he created all things, both visible and invisible. He said throne and dominion. Amen. So if you are asking for promotion, he created the new position you are looking for. Amen. If you are asking for elevation, whatever height you ask, he created that height. Praise the Lord. I mean, so he created all things. He created all things, both visible and invisible. Say, ask, and you shall be given. So why then should you doubt him? Amen. Says what? Whatever you are asking is what that created it. He has power. He has control over all the creator. So surely, when you ask, he will release unto you. Praise the Lord. Maybe I need to tell you one more of his status. Amen. Now, aside that he created all things, because somebody might be quick to say, the fact that he created all things does not necessarily mean he holds all things. Amen. For example, maybe the owner of Toyota manufacturing company appear, and then you have contact with him, and say, you know, you are so good. I want to just ask for any Toyota products. I will give you. Amen. And then you see a Toyota product going and say, okay, I want this one. And they stop the Toyota. I said, you know my name? I am Iozaki, the creator of this vehicle. You know? So I'm taking this vehicle from you and giving it to this. Is it possible? Yes, truly is one that created it, but he does not own it. Amen. Ownership have changed. So it is possible. Somebody might say, well, it is possible that he created it, but my not necessarily owns it. Amen. But that is not the case of the one that is promising us. Amen. He created all things. The fourth thing I want you to look at the world, he owns all things. Amen. He owns all things. Why? He created all things for himself. Amen. Haggai chapter 2, verse 8. Haggai chapter 2, verse 8. What does it say? Haggai 2, 8. God said, silver is mine. Gold is what? Is mine. So all those people that are mining silver and gold, they are mining what does not belong to him, to them. You understand what I'm saying now? He said, silver is what? Silver is mine. Amen. I created it and I created it for myself. Amen. He owns it. Amen. He owns it. Psalm 24, verse 1. Psalm 24, verse 1. The heart is of the Lord. And the what? The fullness thereof. Amen. He owns the heart. He owns everything, including you. Amen. So whatever you are asking, the one that says ask will be given is the owner. When the owner says you will be given, is there any reason to doubt it? Is there any reason to doubt it? Amen. Now you go, you get to the restaurants and you meet the owner of the restaurants. And the owner of the restaurant said, well, any food you want, don't worry. Just place order. You know, place order and take and go. Don't worry. Amen. Do you have cause to doubt him or her? No. Why? He's the owner. You understand what I'm saying? He holds the food. Amen. A waiter might give you that promise. You might be actually careful because he's not the owner. If madame catch you taking that thing, madame can stop it. But if madame is the one that say, collect any food and go. Amen. You can be sure no one can challenge you. The waiter cannot say, hey, don't take that meat, don't take that meat. I reserve that meat for my customer. Madame will say, are you okay? I say somebody should take meat, you are saying you reserve. You understand what I'm saying now? Huh? The waiter cannot stop. Why? Because the owner of the restaurant. So God owns everything. Psalm 50, verse 10 to 11. You know, he said, the beasts in the forest are mine. A thousand cattle upon the hill, they belong to me. Amen. Oh, he said, the world is mine. If I'm hungry, I don't need to tell you. Amen. So the one that says, ask, you will give me. He owns whatever you are asking. Genesis chapter 14, verse 19 and 22. Genesis 14, 19 and 22. Abraham called him possessor of heaven and earth. That is, the owner of heaven is also the owner of the earth. Praise the Lord. So friends, maybe a little, give me one more, then we'll pray. Amen. Why should I believe his status? What are his status? Number one, he's not a man that you lie. So it means he can't lie. Number two, is the Almighty. Oh. Number three, he created whatever I'm asking. Really? Number four, he is the owner of whatever I'm asking. Amen. Now number five, the status of the one that said, ask and you shall be given. He has given you something more and better than whatever you are asking. Amen. There is nothing you can ask him. He has given you something much, much better. Even when you do not ask. You understand what I'm saying now? Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. You see, he that spared not his what? His only begotten son. Amen. Is fear not his only, the only thing precious to him, his only begotten Son. Romans 8:32. But he freely delivered him to us. Look at that scripture, everybody. He said, he that spare not his own Son, but deliver him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Amen. Even when you don't ask, he gave you the most precious possessions. Amen. How much more you ask? Now imagine you have, baby, imagine you have you have an uncle that loves you so much and is so rich. Amen. And the uncle loves you so much. And that uncle is so rich. You know, so one day you go to his mansion, and his mansion, he has so many vehicles. He has Rolls Royce, he has Bentley, he has Ferrari, he has Lexus, he has Toyota. The compound is filled with vehicles. Amen. You know, and then your uncle was taking you around his compound, showing you all he has, and say, oh, you see this this Rolls Royce is called Ghost. It's the best, it's the latest. You know, I just got it. It was specially made for me. In fact, I placed the order in 2015. It took them 6 years to finish making it. You know? And then you saw it. It's so beautiful. It's so fine. You understand? See? And he was telling you that, see, among all my cars, this is my best car. Because no one has such a car like this. And you look at it, you admire it. You understand what I'm saying? You look at the car, you know, and you're there. And it took you around, show you all that, show you Bentley, show you Ferrari, show you all those stuff. You saw even he asked what to buy, he asked what to cycle, he asked bicycles also, so many of the bicycles there. Amen. And then when you went back to the city room, you know, you went back, you kept looking at that Rolls Royce. You kept admiring it. Amen. Then suddenly, you know, you are lost in thoughts. Eh? And you spoke out. How I wish the one that owns that Rolls Royce. And they also say, what do you say? And you came out, sorry, sir. And I said it to your boss. I said, no, it's not. And then you got to just talk. Amen. And your birthday is next week. Amen. And then suddenly your birthday comes, and then you wake up, you know, in your house, and then you receive a visitor, and they brought down Rolls Royce to you. And they say it's a gift from your uncle for your birthday. I mean, it will be difficult for you to believe that, because you knew that that was like his best of cars. And you knew that it took the company 6 years to manufacture that, and there is no other type in the world. Amen. But just gave it because he saw that you loved that car for your birthday. Now imagine next year's birthday. Eh? You went to the same uncle's house, you know, and then your uncle said, don't worry, I will surprise you anything you want for your birthday. And you are going around in his compound, and you saw a bicycle. And you like that bicycle. And that bicycle is what you want for your birthday gift. Eh? And you begin to talk to yourself, I don't know now if I have this bicycle, whether you will give me. Will you give me? Will you not give me? Is that not madness? Eh? Do you think if he asks for that bicycle, he will not give you? He has told you, ask anything for your birthday. And then what you want, among all the everything you have seen, is just one of the bicycles. Amen. So, do you think if you ask for that bicycle, he will not give you? Answer me, church. He will give you. How are you sure that he will give you? Last year, he gave you Rolls. Can you compare the value of Rolls Royce to the bicycle? If you did not even ask, but because he loved you, he gave you a Rolls Royce. Amen. Now, he said ask, and you want to ask for a bicycle. Do you think he will not give you? You can be certain that what? He will give you. Praise the Lord.
Now, that is the status of the one that promised us. He has given you a rose cross before. Whatever you are asking now is just a bicycle. If he can give you a rose cross without asking, how would he give you a bicycle that you are asking for? That is what that scripture says. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. He gave us his only begotten son. He said, how will he not freely, but he also give you every other thing? What is that that you have been asking? You are going to get it this time around.
Amen.
You have been asking for the fruit of the womb. What is the fruit of the womb compared to Jesus he has given you? You will get that fruit of the womb today.
Amen.
Oh, you wanted to be married in year 2021. But the marriage has not, in fact, there is no hope for the marriage. Don't worry, you will ask, you will be married in year 2021.
Amen.
Ah, holy Shami.
Amen.
You want to be promoted. They've done the promotion. Now, whatever, they've released. Amen. So, as far as you are concerned, 2021, you can't be promoted. Now, lie. You will ask for that promotion.
Amen.
This year, you'll be promoted again.
Amen.
Remember, within all things are possible. Don't say, the pastor does not know the policy in our account. They only promote once in a year. This year, promotion is, and I pray, and I ask for, and I believe. I was so sure I will be promoted 2021. But that's fast. No problem. 2021, you ask, you will ask again. You will get in 2021.
Amen!
You know, I remember one of my daughters then, one of the parish that was pastor in Suriname, he wanted to travel from vacation to UK. Amen? And then she was saving money for her leave. Suddenly, the money that she saved was not enough to travel for the vacation. So she was hoping that, okay, no problem, at least I've gotten so much. Next year is so certain now. I just need to have little to read. Then suddenly there was a need in the church. We had the program, we had the guest minister, and the guest minister was in the spirit, and he said, he looked at our choir stand, he said, please, play me ocean. And they were looking for ocean in our keyboard. Our keyboard then was the keyboard you were giving that they started the parish with. Amen. And that keyboard was so old that it's no longer among the catalog of Yamaha. You understand him? You know, when you look for the catalog, that keyboard was not there. Amen. To tell you how very old that model was. You know, so the man was saying, play me ocean. The spirit was moving. And then the organist was looking at me. You know, oh, no ocean here. Amen. Then suddenly the man of God went to the keeper and saw a keyboard. There was no ocean. Amen. I felt the beats in my eyes. I said, what's the problem? We'll buy another keyboard. The one that has sea and ocean. Amen. So I tell the church, I don't have one. All of them saw what happened. So we are going to buy keyboard. We must buy the keyboard. Amen. So we tried to raise the sheep. And then our sister said, well, this money was not enough to travel to UK. Let me sew it. Now she sold the money and then we bought the keyboard. And then the word of the Lord came to her. Amen. That, the word of God came to all that gave the money for the keyboard. Now, the interesting thing was that was around August. Amen. Suddenly, at the end of that month, the company that is working, amen, just decided to close for the year. They said they closed for the year. So they pay all the staff 30-month salary and allowances. Amen. And her own, because she was one of the managers, was big enough that she was able to travel to UK. Amen. Now that is not where I'm going. She has gone to, she thought she can't go that yet, she'll go next year. Amen. But God did it, she went that year. You know that when December came, they closed for the year again. They still paid them 13 months salary and allowances. Amen. Now, I won't mention the company so that you go and tell them so that they won't discover that whether it's an error or it's not an error. And I know the hand of God was in it. Now, what am I saying? A company closed twice in a year. They close. You understand what it means? They close for the year. I'm paying allowance in the year. It is not possible for God making possible. So what am I saying to you? Whatever you have asked for God that you have not gotten this year, 2021,
you are going to ask today and you will get this time around.
Why? The one that said ask. I have told you five of his attributes. Amen. That is enough for you to hold on to and get what you are looking for. Let's bow down our head. Let's bow down our head before we pray. Now, when Jesus said, you know, ask, he was not saying to the whole world. Amen. He was only speaking to the disciples. He was only speaking to those that have given their life to him. He was only giving to those, speaking to those that have covenant relationship with him. Praise the Lord. If you are here, every head bow, every eye closed, you are not born again. That promise is not for you. But you can give your life to Christ now, and then you'll be entitled to that promise. So I'm making a call. You want to surrender your life to Jesus Christ. You want the God of heaven to become your heavenly Father. Lift up your hands. I want to pray with you. Now, it doesn't matter how long you have been coming to church. I'm saying, are you born again? Or maybe you are born again before. But remember, maybe it was because you asked, you did not get. That's why you got frustrated. You backslide back into the world. But now you want to retrace your step. Now that you know that when you ask, you get. If there's anyone I would like to pray with you, lift up your hands if there's anyone. I don't have the time. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let's rise on our feet, everybody. Rise on your feet. Rise on your feet. Rise on your feet. Rise on your feet. Now, want to pray this prayer, but ask this at the back of your mind. Why should I believe that everything I ask now, I will get? Because the one that said, as you ask, I will be giving. It's not a man that he should lie. So it means he's not a liar. Number two, is the Almighty. Number three, he created whatever I want to ask. Number four, he holds whatever I want to ask. Number five, oh, he has given me something much, much precious than whatever I'm asking now, even when I did not ask. Amen. What do you want? You are going to get it. Close your eyes. Say, Father, thank you for your promise that can never fail. Thank you, because I know as I ask now, surely I will receive. Open your mouth. Life, there is a super, Holy Spirit. You want you, Riba. Ah, Mary, for you, Riba. Only walking in, how she read, only come, how she fall. Ah, oh, God, about Mary, near and rocky. No software, no, for you, I won't put on Riba. It will pay any to some of the world, Riba. Thank you, because you are not a man that you should lie, neither are you a son of man. Oh, that you should repent. Whatever you say, you will do. Father, thank you. Father, thank you. Father, thank you. Father, thank you. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
You want to pray this prayer? You want to command? Whatever power that have been working against your life, that have not allowed you to see what you have been asking for, that is not allowing you to see what you have been seeking for, that is not allowing you to see what door you have been knocking, let that power collapse today. Let it die by fire. Don't buy yet, Jacadi. Don't even, and he said, oh, the river.
Whatever today that God is not dry. As far as open us, 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 walking against my life, my destiny. Say any power, anything whatsoever. Walking against my life, my destiny. Enough is enough. Say enough is enough. Wherever you are now, expire by fire. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. What is that that is working against your life? That is working against your destiny? See what you are looking for. Don't allow you to get what you are asking. Command the power, let it expire. Let it expire now. Let it expire now. Let it expire now. Is it a covenant that is in place? Not allow you to see what you are looking for. Is it that there is a covenant in place that is not allowing you to get what you are asking for? Command it to expire. 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 Laka Sakata. Yadalaboja. Laka Daba. Robo Zada. Yakinibo. Sutikaya. Laka Takaya. Menebo. Oya Pache. Pourquoi pas au courant? Ton palier est fila. Ton palier est titagani. Dieu vient au Ruba. Dieu vient au Ruba.
Let it expire today.
ask you, you shall be given. You want the blood of Jesus to separate you now from everything you don't want in your life again. Let the blood of Jesus, let it separate you from that invisible power, from that invisible hand that is holding your life, from that invisible hand that is fighting you. I don't know the conflict. I don't know the situation. I don't know the enemy that is fighting you. Some, what is fighting them is very close to them. Amen. What is fighting them is living with them. Amen. What is fighting them is what? It's living with them and they don't know. Amen. They are living together. So when they run and they come back, when they are talking, they are exposing themselves to the thing that's what? That is troubling them. Remember a man in Abuja, some people have shared this story here with you before, this case. Amen. He was doing a business. He was one of the major distributors of airtime, recharge cards for all the mobile lines. Amen. And his sales daily is millions. He's not selling recharge cards one. He's one of the major. So his daily sales anytime I visit him, he's always counting money. Amen. But it was so bad that I didn't know that he does not even have a house of his own. He's squatting in the quarters that somebody helped him to deliver him. How can somebody be making daily sales of millions? Until one day, his younger brother told me that I should please help them, that he has not been able to go travel for the past 9 years to go and see their parents. And I said, why? He said, he doesn't have transport money. I said, how much is transport money? He said, 5,000 will be enough to go and come back. Who owns the business? He said, it's the one that owns the business. One day, I talked to him, and he opened up. He said, well, he doesn't know what is happening. I said, tell me the truth. Are you sure you are the owner of this business? He said, he's the owner. Are you saying there's no profit you are making from this thing? He said, there's profit. And so, what's happening to the profit? He said, himself cannot explain. Amen. No problem. Brought him for a night of fire on the mountain. The power of God set him free. He went home. And that day, that night, amen. He said, when he got home in the morning, that he discovered that things were, that something was going wrong around him, but he could not fix it. He could not place his hands on it. In the night, around some minutes to 3 a.m., he called me and began to pass. He began to lament, man of God, please, help me. What is the problem? He said, cake, slap him. I said, cake, slap you. Cake, I said, cake, how can cake, slap you? I said, what is cake? He said, cake. Cake, slap you. I said, what is cake? And because the cake that I know does not have hand now. The cake that I know cannot do anything now. He said, cake, man of God, cake. And where did cake? Where did cake? That cake. I said, how come? And he told me that he was sleeping. And he thought he was dreaming. That suddenly his wardrobe opened up. And the cake came out of his wardrobe and stretch and grew a hand and give him a dirty slap. Wow. And that the slap was so much that it twisted his mouth and swollen his face. The pain woke him up. Amen? And then blood started gushing out from his mouth. And he opened the wardrobe and lo and behold, the cake was there. I said, where is the cake? He said, see the cake. See the cake. I mean, he was talking to me on the phone. See the cake. I said, where? See where? He said, see it. It's still there in my wardrobe. I said, well, I will pray for you from here. This is to 3 a.m. You know, pray. We command, we destroy the power of the cake. I asked him to pour oil and to set that cake and place that match.
bed. I went to go and sleep the next day. When I saw him, his face was like Michelin. You know that Michelin advert? So they act. I said, one slap from cake is what swollen your face like this. What about if you have given a second slap? I'm sure the head will have come out. Amen. Now, but that is how I'm going. Where I'm going was that. That was the power that was responsible for his ambitions. Amen. Because the man that was not able to raise 5,000 naira to see his mother, amen, in a short while, he was able to buy two vehicles. That same year, he traveled with his own vehicles. Now, there was a power in the wardrobe that was receiving his daily sweats. You know, when he come back, he dressed from the wardrobe, you know, and he go back, when they remove his clothes and hang it back, it was not his clothes that is hanging, it is his daily sweat that is handing over to that power. But he never knew the power was there. He never knew somebody was staying with him. He never knew there was a power taking his profits. Amen. Now, I don't know, maybe if you are living with that is responsible, let the God of Jesus, let it separate you this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. You have to cry to the God of Jesus. Let it bring separation between you and every strange power dropping your life, dropping your destiny. That's one answer to that prayer. You cry to the God of Jesus. Let it bring separation between you and any contrary situation you have found yourself. Let the God of Jesus, let it separate you. Are you ready for your deliverance? Are you ready for your freedom? Say, blood of Jesus Christ. Say, blood of Jesus Christ. Say, blood of Jesus Christ. Separate me now from every power, from every spirit, dropping my life and my destiny. Say, blood of Jesus Christ, separate me now from every contrary situation. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray. Oh yes, take me, and Jesus. And Jesus, oh yes, me. Oh yes, me, ya, go, 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 Et que Dieu nous jamais, jamais la royer. Et que Dieu nous jamais, et que Dieu nous jamais, et que Dieu nous jamais. Jamais y a pas de vie, jamais y a pas de bon, jamais y a pas de bon. Et que Dieu nous jamais, et que Dieu nous jamais, et que Dieu nous jamais. Lord of Jesus, Lord of Jesus, open your mouth, cry for that blood, cry for that blood. If God can give you Jesus. He said, it's mad, I will not allow to run for you. Cry for that blood. Let him walk your deliverance. 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 Ra-da-da-da-da. Le-ko-su-ta-da-ba. E-de-de-su-yami. E-de-de-su-yami. Lo-mo-do-pa. Yami-ya. Po-pa-pa-ra. I'm going to go to the house. Open your mouth and pray. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are moving your mouth every day. He's all encompassing. So our solutions. So instead of coming to one by one, let God just separate you. Maybe there is a
armor that has bowed, that you will not get let the blood of Jesus separate you.
Amen.
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 If there's an armor that is blocking your way, let the blood of Jesus separate you. Amen. If there's a demon that is an opener, let the blood of Jesus separate you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are going to pray with this song. That prayer, Christ on your feet, you will clap your hands, the choir will help me. And the God of Jesus will walk your deliverance now. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And yet, oh, dear, dear Lord. Oh, my soul be sick. Oh, what you are saying, Lord? Wait, wait, wait. Whatever is the calling, whatever is the power, whatever is the spirit, let the God of Jesus set you free.
Amen.
Is it that there is a covenant? There is somebody that there is a covenant between you and the river. So the river determines what comes to you. So it is when there are peace to the river that we allow whatever you are asking for to come. So it doesn't matter if you are ask. There's a covenant between you and that river. In the river, we allow you to come in good talk. Today, let the God of
Jesus
from that moment.
Amen.
So that moment.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What's the call for my microphone? Well, at the two as the one. Entry at the two as anyone. Amen.
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 So the blood is set you free from that covenant. Maybe there's a covenant between you and anything that is not allowing you to move forward. Let the God of Jesus set you free.
Amen.
Maybe what is going on here, yeah, they don't know the source.
Amen.
I remember the sister in Abuja, things were so bad for her and the family. And we'd be praying, we'd pray, 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 pray. It's like nothing was happening. Amen. The husband business started prosliding until the business crashed. And the husband believed the wife is responsible. And the man began to maltreat the sister. We have to deal with that. And we kept encouraging her, don't worry, just be patient. Amen. Until one day, the sister got tired. I said, Pastor, I'm tired. I want to go back to my father's house. You can't do that. You can't do that. You know you're a Christian. Amen. And one night, it was a night of deliverance. The Lord opened our eyes and we saw that she was married to a tree in her father's compound. Have you heard that before? Married to a tree. Kukute? Eh? Afe, Afele Afu Kukute? Kukute to Afele Afele Babae? I saw the Kukute. I said, sister, what is this? You are married to a tree. And then she confirmed it. After that, he said, no wonder that she is always longing to go back to her father's compound in Imo State.
Amen.
And that no wonder she always have a dream that she see herself always weathering, you know, weathering the tree in her dream. Weathering. I said, you are taking care of your husband. That's your husband. You are taking. You thought you were wet today, tree. So that night, you said it's your night of deliverance.
Amen.
A sister that we've been talking that was operating, suddenly want to start prayer. Everybody was watching and you say, you know, and the sister turned to confront to face pastor. No. Ah, sister, it's me. You know?
But I know it was not an English Obuse. It was a shrub that said, I lie within our front. But that might the Lord set that free from that Obuse. Now, it was sometime in the month of October. You know that suddenly things turn around for her and the husband. By December, the other business has died completely. Eh? By December, the husband bought her Toyota Camry, the one they call Muscle, to apologize for the ill treatment and say, you are the source of my success. She bought the car. I dedicated the car. So I'm not telling you something that did not happen. You understand what I'm saying now? Now, she never knew that it was Kukude that she was married to that was the source of her problem. She never knew. Amen. She has prayed all manner of prayer. Pray against all the in-laws, all the witches in the in-laws house. She never knew there was no witch in the in-laws house. That is in her father's compound. That is further reported from. So whatever is the source of hope too, the blood of Jesus is separate you. You are going to close your eyes. You will sing that song. And you can tell the Lord that blood that is more than any blood. Over to me, see, come and deliver me. Angel who surely cover me. The blood that flows in Calvary. Over to me, see, come and set me free now. Amen. So that if you don't, I've interpreted for you. Amen. Your deliverance is to manifest now. Eh? Is there anyone that doesn't understand you over here? Let me see. Let me see if I can help you. Lord, that is more than glory. Come and save my life. Lord, that is more than glory. Come and save my life. Come and save my life. Come and save my life. Come and save. Okay, let me play it again. Now this is because of you, I'm going through all this. Lord, that is more than. Thank you.
Lord of Jesus, 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 Lord of Jesus.
Rata sete li hende li go shivi li Lika satara mo sakata Radada mo sike li go jagada Yagada Yagada mo suku takada Yakata Radada mo suto bi hada. Thank you Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
You are going to take up prayer once again for the last time. But this time around, your life is so already for the Lord. You are set in it for your freedom. Let the fire of God set you free now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let the fire of God set you free now. Are you ready for the fire of God? The blood has soaked you so the fire can walk easily now. Any encounter, the fire will bring separation now. Whatever power, whatever covenant, whatever chain that is holding you, whatever pronouncement, whatever stranger that is dwelling in the inside of you, we want to choke them with the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. What is that situation you want to be free from? From the power of your Father's house, from that foundational covenant, you will be free today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will close your eyes. You will clap your head. You will sing this song with all your heart. Amen. And the fire will draw wonders on you. Amen. The song says, set me free. Set me free. Holy Ghost fire. Set me free. Set me free, Holy Ghost fire. Set me free. Amen. Are you ready to be free? Are you ready to be free? Set me free. Set me free. Holy Ghost fire. before giving your deliverance.
Libura da satapala da kosa paliala. Ipura da kasata. From the crown of your head, let the fire flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Don't be distracted. Go, let it flow. Let it flow. That covenant between you and that river. The fire is separating you. I set that river on fire. I set that river. I set that river on fire.
See that water. That strange water. That strange water in the inside of you.
Maliku shutala na kushikeria. Lira da satali yala wogo shikeri yala. Ready so to be here. Inola. Inola. Inola Jesus.
Now you're going to take, you're going to go with this song. Oh, there's some purpose in some people's life that the fire want to enter and come to us now. Amen. Don't be distracted, something is happening. Oh, there is somebody here. Wow, wow, what a wonderful deliverer. Hey, you have been bedwetting. See, I'm under bedwetting. That bedwetting comes from them today. I just see, there's a strange water, there's a strange water that always flows through you. It always comes through you. You don't want to bedwet, but the water normally flows because it is not ordinary water, so you don't have control over it. God has just set you free now. In the name of Jesus Christ. You want to receive this fire. Say, Inola, 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 Jesus. When you are here, Inola, great fire, great fire, fire of Jesus. Now, you want to direct the fire to enter into you. Jesus made, John said, when it comes, we will baptize you with Holy Ghost and with fire. Amen. Let that fire enter you, the fire of Jesus. When the fire enter into you, every deposit of darkness will begin to jump out. In the name of Jesus. So you will close your eyes, you will clap your hands. You will sing that song militantly. Amen. As you sing that song, the fire will descend on you and enter into you. Even right into your foundation and begin to work with you.
this three times. You stretch forth your hands to God. You shout it three times. Then you keep quiet. What are you going to shout? You will shout, fire of God enter me now. Are you ready? Stretch forth your hands. Stretch forth your hands. Stretch forth your hands. You guys, face that fire. Stretch forth your hands. You shout it three times. Then you keep quiet. And the fire begin to work in you. Are you ready? One, two, go. Fire!
Yes. I love the fire. Lukutakada, Lika, it's flowing. Like a stream, it's flowing. Like a stream, it's flowing. It's flowing like a stream. Fire! You can take more, Chakada. You can take more. Yes. You can take more. You can take more. Take more of the fire. Yes, I set you on fire. Yes. Bam! In the name of Jesus. Don't be distracted. Let it flow through you. Let it flow through you. Alaka, let it get in. Take the fire. I sent you away. Catch the fire.
The fire is flowing.
Yes. Every hindrance, makatakatukata. Lord, let the fire flow. Let it flow. Now. I break every resistance of darkness. Lekusa dagada kuda. I set you ablaze. I set up this. Nah.
Lord, your fire. Lakashakata. From the crown of your head, let that fire flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Every stranger of darkness, I spoke them out. I smoke them out. Likata. Take the fire. Dig it to more. Don't be distracted. Rika Satalibush, Shukulibush. Yigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigigig